Well, here I am, fourth day in Oregon. So the kiddos had to go to school today, and so I decided on my last day in Oregon, I want to come down and hike the Redwoods. So here I am, surrounded by huge trees, and it's gorgeous. It's sprinkling a little because it's Northern California / Southern Oregon. Of course, it's going to be raining. But I'm gonna go hiking through some of the Redwoods, and then I'm gonna go down to the tide pools and see a lighthouse, and I'm still gonna have an awesome day even though it's a little bit sprinkling. The temperature feels nice, and I'm thoroughly gonna enjoy my time hiking through the Redwoods. It's gonna be mystical and magical. Hey, I found an actual trail. Fancy that. It started raining a little bit harder, so I busted out my rain jacket. But yeah, I'm gonna go find some big trees. I wonder if I'll find any. Man, this place is beautiful and cool and massive trees. Holy bananas. Let me flip this around. Oh, it's not gonna let me. Maybe? Nope. Anyways, I'm gonna go hiking and find some big trees, take some pictures, and enjoy Northern California / Southern Oregon. Hey guys, look, I found some really big trees. They're super tall, and they're ginormous, and they're like got big trunks. And guys, look. Look, I can't even put my arms around them. They're really big trees. They're cool. Wow. A bunch of big trees. Holy cow. Such a magical place. A root! This poor tree fell over.
It's a big root.
Bunch of trees falling over. Bunch more big trees. Oh my god, that's a big one. Makes me dizzy looking up. Another big tree. So cool. I love the Redwoods. I love Oregon. Well, the rain started coming down a little bit harder, and as you can see, I'm all wet. That rain jacket didn't do much to help my case. Yeah, it was raining a little bit harder, but it was a still nice hike. I thoroughly enjoyed it. It's so humid though that my glasses keep fogging up and I can't see out of them. So I have to keep cleaning off my glasses. So yeah, I've thoroughly enjoyed hiking in the Redwoods on Walker Road. I'm about to go, it's almost low tide, so I'm about to go down to Crescent City and go over and see the lighthouse there and see if I can see some tide pools suggested to me by Cambry and Steve. So I'm gonna go do that now. Hey look guys, I'm at the lighthouse and I found my first sea star in the tide pools. Check it out. See that little guy? Let me pick him up. Ew, he's slimy. Oh, cute little sea star. Oh, my first sea star. Precious. And there's a bigger one over there. Here, I'm gonna come show you. Put him back down. Entered these tide pools, and yeah, there's another big sea star. See that one? I'm gonna pick him up too. Hold on, I'm gonna switch the camera. Check it out! Another sea star. My second sea star that I found. I'm gonna pick him up.
Whoa! It's kind of slimy underneath. Feels weird. Oh, he's hanging onto that rock. Let go, I want to hold you. Oh, he's got all kinds of rocks underneath. Ew! Yeah, that's so cool! I found my first sea star. Well, this is technically my second sea star, I guess, but still cool. So, on Cambry's and Steve's suggestion, I came down to the Crescent City Beach, down on the left side, the south side of the beach, because there's lots of sand dollars here, and I found evidence of lots of sand dollars. They're all broken in half, though. Probably the birds like to eat them, because every single one I've found are all broken in half. And I've found tons of empty crab shells. So this is like bird feasting ground right here. But yeah, it's kind of cool to see all these sand dollars, even if they are broken. Because I've never seen a sand dollar in its natural environment. But yeah, you can see, I mean, there's some one right there. You just walk around along this beach, and pretty much everywhere you see a white spot is a broken sand dollar. So there's one right there, and there's one right there, and there's one right there. Yeah, lots and lots of broken sand dollars. That's kind of cool. I'd be interested to see, like, find out how you find, a whole sand dollar. I wonder if they, like, burrow down in the sand, and if you can find them by, like, digging up the sand. I don't know. But it'd be cool to find a whole sand dollar. Don't think I'll find this one this trip. So Cambry and Steve, if you ever come down here, you'll have to see if you can find a whole sand dollar. Yeah. That's a big tree. I'm in another grove, Stout Grove Trail. It's along the river, so I'm hoping I can hike along the river for a little bit. Cambry and Steve say it's a gorgeous trail, so I'm giving it a shot. I found the river. It's gorgeous. So blue. I love it. I'm just hiking here next to the river for a little bit. I'll turn around in a little bit and go back to the Stout Grove Trail. But I just thought I'd take a moment and document this beauty. I love the clouds amongst the trees, and it's so misty. There's been, in all the groves that I've hiked to and through today, there's been like a mist quality in clouds. It's been really cool. Otherworldly. They're dancing to the bye-bye song.
Okay, wait.
Now it's time to say goodbye. I'm leaving the Nelsons.
Bye, Bob. We love you.
2, 3, backflip. 1, 2.
I don't know if that's safe.
Freeze midair! That's a talented backflip!
This is what I want! Wait, guys, let's jump in a circle and then go high car.
Bye!
Cute, come on! So do this, and then we'll give the girl a one circle. One!
Alright.
Goodbye!
Like a brand new pair of jeans. I feel like taking chances. I feel a lot like 17.
back when I close my eyes. When I close my eyes.